now pick that right arm and right leg up one more time, and maybe stretch it a little further. Feel longer and taller, and release that, stretch that left side, stretch, stretch, so the left arm and leg is 2 inches off the ground, they're reaching in opposing directions, and release. Hug the knees into the chest, gently rock side to side, massaging that low back into the earth. I don't own the rights to the music. It's gentle yoga, center for optimum. And stop and center, pick your head up towards your knee, like round wall, lower the head down, and then raise the arms and legs up and just make some circles with your wrists and your ankles. Reverse direction. Take your time, shake it out, and then hug it in. Pick your head up towards your knees one more time, and then open up like a starfish. Hug it in so the hands can be on the knees, the calves, or the heels. Open up like a starfish. Good. One more. Hug it in. Starfish. And lower down. Now, let's place our hands in airplane position. Palms down, directly out from the shoulders. Bend the knees to the chest. Squeeze those knees together. Activate the feet. Push the palms into the earth and tick-tock side to side. So we don't want the shoulders to come off the ground. We're just tick-tocking our knees side to side. Squeezing those knees together like you have an important piece of paper between the knees. Just inviting in more ease of movement. One more time, next from your knees, come all the way over to the right. Let them stay there. Place that right hand to the outside, that left knee, and gaze over to the left. Big breath in, complete breath out, in and out the nose. Good, one more, inhale, and exhale. This is a natural spinal adjustment, just enjoy it. Place that right hand in airplane position. Squeeze those knees together. Gracefully bring your knees all the way over to the left. Turn to look to the right. Let's put that left hand to the outside, that right bent knee. Big inhale breath. Slowly exhale out the nose. One more. Replace that left hand back in airplane position. Squeeze those knees together. Gracefully bring them all the way over to the right and straighten the left leg. Maybe the left foot comes towards the right hand or just in that direction and turn to look towards the left. Breathe deeply and on the exhale, let it all go and soften. Squeeze the knees together, place that right palm down, squeeze the knees back towards the ceiling, gracefully bring both knees all the way over to the left. And now if you want to straighten that right leg, putting the right foot towards the left hand, and turn to look to the right. Again, reconnect to the breath. Lower the head down. Let's put our right middle index finger on that right kneecap. Our left middle index finger on the left kneecap. Open up the knees wide. Push them away from the body. Draw them together and bring them back to the heart space. So make these circles in opposing Close the eyes. Let my voice guide you. Take your time. Tune into your innermost self in your practice today. And just reverse direction wherever you're up. The most important aspect of your practice is your breath. Keep it deep, smooth, even. Next time the knees are together, just keep them there. Now let's pick our right leg up, lower that left leg down on your mat. Slide your hands behind your calf, pick your head up, and forehead to your shin. Lower your head down, and just point and flex that right foot. Exaggerate the point, exaggerate the flex. Circles with that right foot and ankle. Reverse direction. Good. Stop at center. Spread out the toes, then curl them in tight upon the foot like a fist. Open them up. Curl it in. One more time. Open up. Curl it in. And just point and flex one more time. Bringing more circulation and mobility to the foot and ankle. Our feet hold us up all day. Good. Stop at center. Slide the hands behind the calf. Forehead to shin. And now, do you have a tie? Okay, you don't need one. Put your left hand to your right leg. You can put it on the outside of your calf. Right hand's airplane position. And guide that right leg over to the left. Turn to look at that right hand. Keep the back of that right shoulder touching the mat. Gaze is over that left shoulder. Flex both feet here. Come back to center, bending that right knee. Interweave your fingers just below that right knee and pull the right knee towards the armpit. Point and flex that right foot. Circles again with that foot and ankle. Reverse direction. And release. Good. Shake it out. Now let's float the left leg up. Let's even it out. Slide your hands behind your calf. Forehead to shin. Lower the head down. Point and flex with that left foot. Try to keep a straight line from the left hip, left knee, and left ankle. Circles with that left foot and ankle. Keep your shoulders relaxed. Reverse direction. Good. Spread out the toes and curl them in. Spread them out, curl them in, one more. Now just point and flex. take that right hand to the outside of that left leg, left hand airplane position, guide that left leg over to the right, slowly and carefully, turn to look to the left. Keep the back of that left shoulder touching your mat. Back to center. Take the left hand to the left leg, right hand on the right hip, and open up that left leg to the left side. Gaze is now over that right shoulder. Notice the difference between one side of the body and the other. You're unilateral. No judgments, just awareness. Come on back and bend that left knee. Interweave your fingers just below that left knee. Anchor the back of the right and left shoulder down. Point and flex that left foot. Circles with that left foot and ankle. Remember, each inhale, push that belly right into that left thigh, reverse direction. Each exhale, pull that knee a little closer. And find stillness. And now bend the other knee into the chest, cross at the ankles, and slowly come on up to a seated position. Sitting up tall, feeling that your sit bones connected to the earth. So let's just roll our shoulders up, back, and down, up, back, down. One more. Up, back, down. And now let's bring them up, back and forward. So we're going in the opposite direction. And release. Now let's shove our shoulders up and we're going to make a ha on the way out. Ha. Squeeze it up tight, tight, tight. Ha. Last one. Tight, tight, tighter. Ha. And shake it out. In order to realize how much stuff we're holding there. So let's bring that right arm up and right ear to right shoulder. And just relax the shoulders. Come on back over to the left side. Hold a lot of stress and tension in the neck and shoulder area. Let it go. Release. Come over to the right. This time we're going to aim that elbow towards the knee. And then we're going to bring it up and back and gaze towards the elbow. Good. Bring it towards the knee. Bring it up and back. Last one. Towards the knee. Up and back. Over to the right, and adding the left fingertips on that left shoulder. And release. Now, let's even that out. Come over to the left side. Just the weight of your hand just to open up the side of the neck. And then aim that elbow towards the knee, and then bring it up and back. Bring it towards the knee. Up and back. One more.
under the chest.
Inhale the chin up to the sky one more time.
Exhale, chin to the center of the chest.
Take the head up in a neutral position and turn the head like an owl all the way to the right.
Back to center like an owl all the way to the left. Back to center.
Drop the chin to the chest. Now either go from shoulder to shoulder like a smile with your chin, or go all the way around in a circle if you don't have any neck issues today.
In reverse direction wherever you're at.
No struggle, no strain.
Inviting softness and gentleness into the body. Allowing it to open up on its own sweet time with gentle encouragement.
One more time around,
and next time drop the chin to the chest.
And just pause there, breathe into the back of the neck. Pick the head up and open the eyes. Good job.
Now let's inhale and reach forward. And then exhale, pick up the knees and just round that back, chin to chest. Inhale, reach and stretch. Exhale it out. Inhale, turning the palms to the sky, gesture of receptivity. Exhale, rounding it out, grounding. So inhale, open and receptive. Exhale, grounding and connected.
Good, one more. Beautiful.
Come on back up and just relax those shoulders. Let's twist over to the right, looking eye level over that right shoulder. Let's twist over to the left. Good. Twist to the right one more time. And twist to the left. Come back to center. Let's bring our arms up and relax our shoulders, taking the right hand down. Push that left hip down and look up towards the left elbow. Good. Turn that palm towards the sky and let it lift you up. And come over to the other side. But really ground that right hip down. Gaze at the right elbow. And then turn and switch from side to side. Feel free to close the eyes. I feel like a weeping willow blowing in a gentle breeze from side to side. Pause anywhere. We want to stay a few extra moments if your body's calling for that. Last one. And then drop the fingertips on the shoulders and just make some big circles with your elbows. Releasing any residual stress that we've been carrying here. Giving it permission to fall away. Reverse direction. Thank you. two more times around. Blessings away from your sit bones and flexing your feet. And then sitting up tall, using your abdominal muscles, turn yourself over that right leg. So inhale, lengthen space, and then exhale, just walk it down. So you're going to look at your right toenail. You're going to soften in between the shoulder blades. We're going to be here for three breaths. So each inhale, flex the foot. So you're trying to get your heel off the ground wherever you're at. And then exhale, just hinge and soften. Slowly walk it on back. Great job. Turn yourself over that left leg. So lift up from the hips. And then inhale and exhale. Just walk it down. Remember, it doesn't matter how close you get to the leg, but you want to flex that foot. You want to lengthen and square off your shoulders. And then just melt down. So each inhale, flex the foot. Each exhale, soften and hinge. One side is going to be easier than the other. One more breath. Slowly come out. Bring it on back. Now let's put our hands to the outside. Bring those legs together and shake them out. So let's inhale the arms up. Exhale, hinge it forward. So forward folds are common, holding on to the shins, the ankles, or the feet, but soften in between the shoulder blades. Good. And come on back. Now let's come into our baby cradle. So take that right leg up in both hands. Pick the leg up first. Again, we're pointing and flexing. So this is really good for the feet and lower legs and circulation. And then bend the knee. We're going to come into that baby cradle. So put the foot in the two hands or into the crook of the elbow. Good. And just sit up super tall. So we let that foot up a little higher if it wants to go. Great. So shoulders relax, pushing the heart forward, and looking happy. We are in yoga. Good. Stop in center. Hug it in. And then let's take that foot and put it to the outside of that left knee. Take the left arm, wrap it around, sit up tall, look eye level over that right shoulder. Counter twist to the other side. And release. Let's put that foot to the inside of your thigh. Bring the arms up, shoulders down, crisscross at the wrists, forehead close to your shin. Slowly come on back and just straighten your legs out and shake them out. Good job. So bless with two sides. A second opportunity. Bring the arms up. Exhale, hinge it forward. So notice if you get a little bit further this time, you may or may not, no judgments, just awareness. Slowly come on back. We're going to put our hands on our thighs just for a little bit of a back bend. Bring your chest and chin up to the sky. And then exhale, push into the hands and round it. Good. So this is like our cat-cow, very similar. Inhale. And then exhale. Just feel that stretch in the upper back. So inhale. Exhale. place that foot to your right inner thigh. Arms up, shoulders down, crisscross at the wrist or head to shin. Back up. Good job. Straighten that leg out, shake it out. So let's make our way into our tabletop position, hands and knees. So set yourself up for success. Knees are hip distance, fingers are wide as starfish, right wrists are right under the shoulders. Come into that cat-cow, drop your belly like a hammock. So chin, chest up to the sky. On your exhale, curl your toes, arch the back, and squeeze out every drop of air. Good. So just toggling the spine from flexion to extension. Go slow and be dramatic. And really feel like the movement is originating in the tailbone and just rippling all the way up. Good. One more. And then just push back to a child's pose, Balasana. Resting the whole central nervous system. Wait for the back. And then slink it forward to that modified cobra. Straight arms and look where the ceiling meets the wall. Good. Look over the right shoulder towards your heel. Look over the left shoulder towards your heel. Walk back through tabletop, standing on the knees. Hook your thumbs, lift it up. Arch back for a nice back bend. Back bends are energizing. Exhale, hands smoothly to the heart center. Good. Back to that child's pose. Balasana. This time, roll on the floor and over towards the right temple. The right forearm will be down on your mat. Look under your left elbow. And then switch it. Left temple you're on and left forearm down, and you're looking under that right elbow. Good. And then one more time each side. You should feel the stretch in the upper back. Good. And then come back through center, slinking forward for our last flow here. So we're in that modified cobra, straight arms, low back is soft. And if you want to bend your knees towards your head, slowly put the feet back down, walk back through tabletop. This time we're going to do a half camel, so we want our knees to be hip distance. We're going to windmill that right hand towards the calf or the heel. And if you'd like a little bit more height, you can curl the toes and bring your right hand towards that heel. Reach that left arm straight up, and then switch. Keep pushing the hips forward. Good. One more time each side. Remember, back bends are energizing. Good. Good form. And switch. And then exhale, hands to the heart center. Make your way into your tabletop, and we're coming to our first and only down dog. So in our down dog, we'll be there briefly. Good. And simply walk your feet to your hands. Let's put your right fist down, bend that right knee, and raise that left arm up to the sky. Shift your weight to your toes. Exhale that left fist down. Raise that right arm up, and left knee is bent. Good. One more time each side. Love a twist. Bending the right knee, left arm is reaching up. Exhale that hand down. This is our last one. Exhale down. Reverse palm dive it up. Arch it back. And exhaling the hands right to the heart center. Beautiful. Great job. So let's look down at our feet. Make sure they're straight like railroad tracks, always setting ourselves up for success. And just roll those shoulders up, back, and down. One more. Up, back, down. Good job. So let's step your right foot forward. We're going to bring our left foot back. We're going to bend that right knee a lot.
more here too.
Good. Straighten that front leg, reach it forward right into your triangle. So you can put your hand on a block or hold on to your shin or ankle. Slowly come on back. Bring the hands to the heart center. Spin that back heel up in the back. And just rock that heel forward and back a couple times. That's good. So we're strengthening the foot, strengthening the ankles, and then slowly bring your back foot to meet your front foot and shake it out. Good job. Before we do the other side, bend your knees, empty coat sleeves, side to side. Good. This is a great release to the low back. Good. And now let's give ourselves a tap on the back. Slowing it down. Good. And now we're going to have our left foot forward and our right foot back. So we want to be 4 feet between our feet. And we like our front heel to line up with our back heel. We want to bend that front knee. We want to pull our left hip back and our right hip forward. We'd like our shoulders over our hips. Arms up. Shoulders down. Beautiful. Good form. Keep directing that knee at the pinky toe side. Open up for that warrior two. Breathing deeply. Straighten the front leg, reaching forward, hinging from the hips, coming right into your triangle. So we're in our triangle. Triangle Utthita Trikonasana literally means happy pose. Slowly come on back. Bring your hands to your heart center, spin that back heel up, and we're just going to move the foot, the back foot, forward and back, giving a big foot stretch. The more mobility we have to our feet and ankles, the better our balance will be. And then back foot slowly to meet your front foot. Shake it out. Good job. So,
fresh blow of grass under a big, tall maple tree. The leaves are vibrant color, yellow, red, orange, and still some green left. With a gentle, crisp breeze, there's blue clouds overhead. Just you and nature in all its splendid glory. With the next passing breeze looking up at the tree's branches, see a yellow leaf up top and watch it let go on the breeze and ride it slowly all the way down to the grass. Thank you. start to bring movement back to your body. Wiggle the fingers, wiggle the toes. Gently rock your head from side to side. Bring the hands overhead. Bring the legs together. Give yourself a great big stretch, like the beginning of a brand new day, full of wondrous opportunity and possibilities. And then bend the knees to chest, rock side to side. Say to yourself, I'm well, I'm happy, I'm peaceful. And just make your way over to your right side, pausing there. Take a moment to thank yourself for giving yourself the healing gift of yoga today and practicing self-care with us. In the words of Benjamin Franklin, always be at war with your vices. Always be at peace with your neighbors. And let each day find you a better person. Come on up to a seated position. Bring your hands out to the sides. Inhale overhead, love to all, light to all, peace to all. And exhale your hands to your heart center. And bow and fold in namaste, namaste. We should always feel good.